We believe that faced by an uncertain and potentially hazardous future as a result of climate change and other dramatic environmental changes, the best contribution we can make is to generate evidence, but not evidence in a vacuum, it's evidence for action. The Centre on Climate Change and Planetary Health was set up in 2019 to coordinate the work across the school on climate change and broader planetary health issues, by which we mean the interaction between environmental change and human health. And it does so by coordinating research, the generation of new knowledge, not just about the impact of these threats, but also about the potential solutions, both adaptation and mitigation.
We look at the sort of two-way relationships between what we eat and our food systems, so what goes into the production of our food and our natural environment and also our health. We work in three different countries, in India, South Africa, and also the UK. One of the key things that we've discovered is that there really needs to be a cross-governmental response to these issues. So to develop these healthy and sustainable food systems, it can't be isolated policy making in health, in agriculture, in the environment. It needs to be coordinated across those departments to make sure that the solutions work for people and for the environment as well.
So we performed this relatively complex analysis linking these high resolution mortality data for the whole England and Wales, disaggregated in more than 34,000 areas across the two countries. And we link this data with the temperature. And therefore, we are able to predict what will be the impacts in the future, actually under different scenarios of climate change. And we will be able to tell how many more deaths, for example, there will be in each area, depending on these different scenarios. And I think this is important also from a scientific point of view, of course, but also from a communication perspective, in order to let the public and politicians know about different actions that can be taken to prevent at least some of these impacts.
West Africa is predicted to be one of the areas that is most affected by extreme heat going forward. So we've been looking at the exposure of extreme heat for pregnant subsistence farmers and how that impacts on the mothers and then also on the babies acutely while still in the womb. I think before this work was done, maybe there wasn't such an awareness around the potential dangers of heat, and particularly subsistence farmers are often missing from the literature. And so we were quite shocked to find that in 33% of field visits, there was evidence of acute fetal strain, so that the heat strain from the mother was being passed on to the baby. By highlighting the problem, we hope that this will then puts pregnant women on the agenda when it comes to adaptations and identify them really as an at-risk group going forward.
So it's this idea of understanding how can we work with a natural environment and natural ecosystem to deliver multiple benefits. Yeah? So I'm predominantly just focused on what we call the affluent sector, so afforestation and land use. Sector and cities really come underneath that because it's all about working with landscapes, you know, in a beautiful park. Yeah, this is like a really natural ecosystem within a really huge city. And there are various ways of understanding what are the health benefits, kind of the key one, the one that's been explored a lot in the literature, are mental health benefits. And I think we saw a lot of that from COVID when everyone was locked down in their houses. I think a walk in the park was very therapeutic. But then there are also other many benefits that have been maybe not as well explored from a public health perspective. And this is around improvement in air qualities. So if you enact some of this nature-based solution in cities, the outcomes or the impact is huge because you're talking about big populations.
So to conclude, really, that the climate crisis is a health emergency. traditionally it's been conceived of as an environmental emergency, but actually at the centre of it, at the heart of it, is the threat it poses to human health. And therefore it's really important that the health community steps up, both the practitioner community, the public health community, but also the research community that has such an important role in developing the evidence base for action.